am Marcus Blake with That Nerd Show. We're here at the 2019 Dallas International Film Festival speaking with the filmmakers behind Jump Shot. And I'm going to allow them to introduce themselves so you know who they are.
I am the director, Jacob Hamilton.
I'm Ty Clark, producer.
I'm Mary Beth Minnis, producer.
Now, for our audience that doesn't know what this is about the man who invented the jump shot. How did you come across Kenny Sailors? Because, I mean, most people don't know who he is.
Yeah, I mean, if you live outside of the state of Wyoming, you've probably never heard the name Kenny Sailors before. And I came across Kenny's story when I found a 2-minute audio interview that somebody had done that talked about just a few things that he accomplished in his time here. The fact that somebody actually invented the jump shot and that could be credited towards somebody caught my initial interest. And then from there, as I began to do a lot more research and dig deeper into who Kenny was, it was one of these things like I think there's this incredibly rich character here that could have a really fascinating documentary.
So one of our staffers, she's also a sports broadcaster, we were having this discussion as we saw this about the film, and I asked the question, well, who did invent it? Because I don't know if anybody really knew that. And he was like, well, there's that guy, George Yardley, that sort of perfected. I'm like, I know. And I'm like, that doesn't seem true. And then we watched the doc, like, wow. We really did not know anything. Were you a huge basketball fan beforehand?
I grew up in Houston in the mid-90s, so like I was a big Rockets fan at the time, and I played basketball up until middle school until they were like, all right, you got to choose the sport, and I was better at football. Ty played basketball, and we originally brought him on as a basketball consultant, and it kind of grew and grew from there. Mary Beth is a huge basketball fan as well. Sometimes she wears her KD. I never know what like brand she's wearing that night as far as shoes go. But I think we all grew up playing sports, and so I think that, you know, sports are the great unscripted drama, and so you never know what you're going to find when you dig into these sports and, you know, the David versus Goliaths and whatnot, and Kenny was that, and his story was that in many different ways. Playing at the University of Wyoming and winning national championship is kind of unreal that they did that, and the fact that he was 5'9" playing the NBA and was as big of a pioneer and game changer for the game as he was, you just never would expect that.
Right. Well, people still credit, you know, like Bob Cousy is one of the greatest shooters of all time, you know, coming from that era, but still that modern day jump shot, it still look weird if you look at film. I what I found more fascinating about this is that coaches were like, no, we just don't play that way, and this is illegal, and we cannot do it. Now, as a basketball star, did you know anything about him before you started?
No, actually, I had no idea who Kenny was himself, and I knew some of the other names that were credited with the possibility of creating the jump shot, but I didn't know who Kenny was at all. And so, as a basketball nerd and just self-proclaimed historian, I started digging really deep when Jake and I met, and I mean, I was just wowed at the innovation and the things the guy was doing beyond the jump shot at his time in the 40s.
And I'm pretty sure, how long of a research paper did you write on all the people that developed the jump shot?
Yeah, I ended up writing a 100-page research paper on the history of the jump shot and the people who developed it for the Naismith Hall of Fame to prove our point that Kenny was the guy. So,
yeah, that's kind of unreal, too. I liked how you kind of ended the film with the possibility of him getting in there and then just kind of the, no, it's not good enough. And I'm like, I figure this is a go-to. What are we debating here? Honestly. Now, the other thing that I found interesting, and I have to applaud you as a filmmaker, is you talked about him being a pioneer for women's sports at the high school that he taught at, that it didn't, gender didn't matter, and they were going to build that. As somebody who's played basketball, what does that mean to you?
Gosh, it means everything to me. I had my father, and I had Coach Max Pope, who believed in me when I was a girl and taught me how to play. And so to see Kenny Sailors bring the game of basketball to the state of Alaska and to women is really touching and inspiring.
So we do have a very nerdy question we want to ask you. But before we get to that, and since we're talking about the jump shot, and we're all basketball fans here, you talked about growing up in Houston during the 90s. I grew up in Chicago during the 90s. So my question is, who do you think has the greatest jump shot? Besides Kenny Sailors, that's for two. We all know that. But who would be your go-to player to have the greatest jump shot?
I mean, you got to look at, you know, the greatest player, the greatest jump shooter of all time that's currently playing the game, Steph Curry. I mean, I don't know how, unless somebody else has a different answer.
For me, it's a personal thing. It's Pete Maravich. I think he just had the most beautiful stroke that, you know, defined range at a time when range wasn't defined either. There was no three-point line. He would have averaged in the mid to late 70s if there was a three-point line in college. So it's, and most of it was jump shot. So
I'm gonna have to go with Steph Curry on this one. I feel like when he shoots the basketball, it reminds me of Roger Federer on the tennis court. There's just something so effortless, and it's amazing.
I want you guys to know you're all wrong. Being from Chicago, it is Michael Jordan.
I won't argue.
I'm not biased at all. Now, the final nerdy question, and this is the toughest question you're gonna get. If you could have a weapon of choice or a superpower from the nerd universe to fight the forces of evil, what would it be for you?
You go first then.
Well, I would want to fly. I mean, I want to be flying like Superman.
That's easy. 100% the Force. 100%.
Ooh, mitochondrion.
Oh my gosh. That's a good one. Because I was taken, I'll go superhuman strength. As cool as it would be to fly, I feel like I'll be able to defend, and super strength. That's what I'm going to go with.
Nice. Great answers. Fantastic documentary. I cannot wait to watch it again. You guys did a great job.
Thank you so much.
It was a pleasure to meet with you.